Well, good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I just want to say thank you very much to Jeff Brand, who is a chief and who is CAL FIRE incident commander here, for his briefing that I just got. And also, I want to thank Chief Dale Walters, who is also with CAL FIRE, for the briefing of the whole state. And I get those briefings throughout the day and also many times throughout the night in order to be up to date of what's going on in the state. As you know, there's 8 fires right now throughout the state, and we want to make sure that we put them out as quickly as possible and there's good coordination. I again want to take this opportunity and just say thank you very much to the extraordinary firefighters. We have, without any doubt, the best, the bravest, the most selfless, toughest firefighters in the world. There's no two ways about that. And again, this shows is an example of how quickly they've put out the fire here. And yesterday, the same in Los Angeles. We have, of course, lost 2 firefighters in Los Angeles. And our condolences and our thoughts and prayers go out to the families and to the friends and so on. I want to say thank you also to Commissioner Poisner for being here today, and to Secretary Bettenhausen from Homeland Security and Emergency Services. Thank you very much. And Sheriff Barner from Plaza County. We want to thank law enforcement. Where's the Sheriff Barner? Right here. Come on out in front. It's very important. We have to see always the fire officials and also law enforcement together. And the reason why that's important is because it's a joint effort. Because whenever you talk about evacuations, that's when law enforcement steps in to make sure that these homes are protected after they're evacuated, and also to coordinate with fire officials. So it's the team effort between fire and law enforcement that makes things happen. And what is great here, again, was good coordination between the locals and the state and also the federal government. And I came here because I heard about the terrible tragedy here, but losing 50 homes or so, and that's always terrible when you lose your home, and we want to make sure that we are there to help and assist in every way that we can. And we, of course, declare the emergency declaration immediately, not only for this area, for Plaza, but also for Monterey County and for Mariposa County, Los Angeles County. And whenever there's an emergency, we immediately jump into action and try to do everything that we can in order to help. The briefing that I just got, let me just bring you up to date. There's 275 acres that have burned so far. There's 50% contained. 50 homes approximately have been destroyed, and 10 commercial buildings have also been destroyed. There have been evacuation. Several communities are under mandatory evacuation. I think the key thing I want to mention also to the people is that when you hear from law enforcement anything about evacuation, follow their orders, because there's so many that think that they have to stay behind and protect their home, but it always they sometimes pay dearly for that. People in Los Angeles were burned because of that. So I think it is important to follow the orders of law enforcement when they ask you to evacuate your homes. The other thing I want to mention is that there is 621 personnel now that are involved in fighting the fires here locally, 90 engines, 3 helicopters, and 18 bulldozers. And on a statewide level, I want to bring you up to date. We have so far, as you know, from the beginning of the year to now, we had 5,400 fires so far. So as you can see, there's a lot of fires. 121,000 acres have been destroyed up until the date. And there's 70 structures in this latest fire. Statewide, 70 structures have been destroyed. 5,900 personnel, firefighters, and so on have been working on these fires. 591 engines have been at work, 56 helicopters, 11 airplanes. 18 firefighters have been injured, and as I said, 2 deaths so far. So this is the latest. Again, I want to say thank you very much to the community for working together. Thank you to the firefighters and law enforcement for the great work they're doing. As you can see, the challenges in each fire are tremendous. Each area has different challenges, but there's one thing in common, and this is it's very dry right now. There's no humidity. The humidity is in single digits. There's tremendous heat. The terrain in most of those locations is extraordinary, very challenging. And a lot of the brush, like in Los Angeles area and so on, has not burned for 40 to 60 years, so there is a lot of brush there, and it burns very quickly because of the dry weather. So we want to say thank you again to the firefighters. And also, there was one law enforcement official that I just met that actually saved a woman's life, that pulled her out of the burning house. So we want to thank him also. Where is
Ken Scogan.
Deputy Ken Scogan. I mean, a true hero. Imagine that you're risking your own life to save someone else's life. That's what those firefighters do. That's what those law enforcement officials do. And this is why they're true heroes. We admire them, and I know that all the people of California admire them. So, again, thank you very much. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask.
Your thoughts as you go through the rubble?
Say again?
Your thoughts as you go through the rubble?
Well, you know, every time I visit those fires, it's painful to see the devastation. And whenever you lose your home, it's terrible to lose anything, but your home, because you have your personal belongings in there, you have your memories in there, you have your documents in there, you have everything that you have gathered and acquired over a long period of time. So it's sad when you see that, when you see everything with nothing left destroyed. So, my heart goes out to these people, and that's why I wanted to come here today, to let them know that we're very much aware of this devastation, and that and we're here, you know, to help the community and everyone.
Governor, does the state have what it needs to combat this fire crisis?
The question is, does the state have everything that it needs for this fire crisis? And I have to say, yes, the number one thing that we have and the greatest asset that we have is the firefighters. Like I said, we have the best firefighters, the best trained and the toughest firefighters. And, of course, they have the best equipment. You always can have more. There's no two ways about that. But we made sure in a budget, when the legislature left me with a $156 million budget hole, that we immediately make the necessary cuts so that we have $500 million of reserves. And this is now paying off, because when you have fires like that, we don't want to worry about where the money comes from. We now have the money, and we will, of course, be very frugal and, be very cautious how we spend it. But we're going to have the money, and we're going to fight those fires as quick as possible. And we have the engines. We, increase the amount of engines. Also, the amount that is in the engines, each engine from 3 to 4 manpower. So all of that, we have the helicopters, the fixed-wing aircrafts, and so on. So we have all of the stuff available, yes. Thank you very much, everybody. Have a good day. Thank you.